Dear students, welcome to the online science class. Hope you all are safe and healthy. In the previous lecture, we got an introduction about crop production. I hope you have read the matter from the snapshots and watched the video carefully. Yesterday, we discussed the first agricultural process, that is soil preparation. Today, we will discuss the second and third process, namely sowing and irrigation. So let's begin. After the soil is plowed, leveled, and fertilizers are added, it's time for sowing. The process of putting seeds in the soil for growing crops is called sowing. There are two ways by which seeds can be sown. Number one is broadcasting or simply scattering by hands. In this method, seeds do not fall at proper spacing. That means in some place there will be more number of seeds and in some places very less number of seeds. And second is using seed drill. Seed drill is a tool which ensures the sowing at correct depth and correct intervals. Here in the picture you can see broadcasting in the first two pictures. And yes, there is one method called transplanting. In this method, seeds are sown in the nursery and then the seedlings or the small plantlets are planted in the fields. For example, rice plant is grown by this method. Here you can see the people transplanting the seedlings. This is a seed drill. In this part of the seed drill, the seeds are filled and here the pipes are there attached to the cultivator and the seeds fall at the correct intervals. This seed drill can be attached to a tractor and can be used very easily. There are certain precautions to be followed while sowing the seeds. This will ensure healthy and good production. Let us see what these precautions are. Only healthy and disease-free seeds should be sown. Seeds should be sown at correct depth. That is, it should not be very deep because if it is very deep, it will not germinate properly. Or if it is not very deep, then it will be eaten away by the birds if it is nearby the surface. Seeds should be sown at proper interval to avoid overcrowding. Because if overcrowding is there, there will be competition for nutrients and sunlight. Plants will grow in a cluster and they will not have a healthy growth. By following these precautions, we can get a very good yield. The next step in farming is irrigation. We know that water is very essential for the crops and the rainwater may not be sufficient. So the crops have to be watered artificially. The process of artificially adding water to the plants is called irrigation. In this slide, you can see both traditional and modern methods of irrigation. While traditional methods, they use large amount of water. There is a lot of wastage of water in the traditional methods. So, it is not very proper to use traditional method nowadays. While modern methods, they use less amount of water and can irrigate a large area of the field. This will conserve the water and this drip irrigation, sprinkler irrigation, that is the modern methods, can be used in water scarce areas. Friends, that's all for today. Dear children, read carefully. Watch the video 2-3 times. And I'm also providing you some questions today which you have to write down in your copy.